live in Silicon Valley, and so I'll say a few words to you about why would IBM pay me to go around the world and meet startups in? And also, why do I live in Silicon Valley and what can we learn from that? So IBM has a view that we spend billions of dollars every year on research and development, but we cannot invent everything, and we cannot think of every innovation ourselves. So we feel it's very important to be part of the entrepreneurial ecosystem around the world so that we can learn something from people like you to see what we're doing and what's new, to see where investors are putting money, where is money going, and why, to see what kinds of new things are being invented, but not just new technology, also new business models. What are new ways of doing business? And to take that information and explain that to my executives all across IBM so that we do better ourselves. We'll be a better company, we will have better products, we will have a better strategy, and we will also meet startup companies who can become business partners. So maybe we will have an alliance with companies we meet, or maybe we will buy some companies because we do a lot of acquisitions every year. And so by becoming part of this startup entrepreneurial ecosystem, we meet investors, we meet startups, and we can improve our business and also be as helpful as we can. Because if we help make you successful, then the economy in Vietnam is better. The tech industry is improved because many people are doing new things. And so it's very good business for everybody if we work together and try to help each other and be as innovative as we possibly can. So that is why IBM has programs for startups and people like me who travel and visit you. Now, in Silicon Valley, where I live, I get to be in a place where I think more than 40% of the startups and investors in the world live. And there are some very special things about Silicon Valley. However, when I travel, many times people ask me, what can I do to have this place be just like Silicon Valley? And that is wrong, because every place is different, and you cannot have Silicon Valley in Vietnam, but you should not, because Vietnam is different from Silicon Valley. You have a different school here, you have different skills, you care about different things, maybe the problems you are trying to solve are different. There will be some things that are the same, but there will be other things that will be unique for you. And I always say that people who are creating new companies, people who are creating startups, can do very well if they try to solve problems that they experience, that they see around them. So if you understand how people live their personal lives here, and if you understand how they work every day, and what problems you face in your life, and or in your family life, or your company, or your co-workers, then you can create something really interesting to solve those problems. For example, I'll give you one or two examples. There is a company in South Africa, near Cape Town, called M4Jam, just the letter M, the number four, and then jam, like jazz musicians jamming. And they have what they call micro jobs. They have a marketplace on their website for people who want to have a very little job for a small amount of money. Because people in South Africa are very poor, and the employment rate is not very good, so a lot of people have no job. And yet, there are companies that would like to hire people for a short period of time. Maybe just 10 minutes, go into the grocers and see if my product is displayed properly, and then send me a text and tell me if it's okay. And for that you get a few rand, or the equivalent of a few dollars. And so this is a business that's very suited to that market. People are unemployed. There are customers who would like to have some small thing done for them. They would have no idea how to meet each other, and so this man developed a marketplace to bring them together. That is a business model for a specific place. And so it's very interesting when entrepreneurs think about the problems in the place they live and can create new things. How many people here have heard of a traffic application called Waze that was bought by Google? It's a crowdsourced traffic application. Instead of buying some expensive thing to try to put in your car or on your bike and try to figure out how to get it out of the traffic, which was very bad this afternoon. We could have used something to help us get around it. This man from Israel felt that it was very difficult to figure out where is their police. Where is there a hazard in the road? Where is there an accident? You know, how do I get around this? And he created a product called Waze that is an application that you use on your phone, and it's crowdsourced. So the people who use it put in the information about what's going on. It actually works very well, and Google bought this for a lot of money. Why did he create this application? Because he was pissed off about the traffic. He hated the traffic, and he couldn't figure out what to do about it. So he created a product and a business to solve a problem that he had himself every day. And so there are a lot of businesses, we could talk for hours about examples of businesses like that, where somebody saw a problem and tried to solve it and created a new business about that. And so that's something you can certainly do here in Vietnam. You know, there are lots of resources, you know, here at the school, of course. IBM itself has software to make available, and I've sent a note about the link to share with the students and faculty about how to have access to free stuff. Free stuff is always good. And it's just possible to learn from Silicon Valley the things that you can do here. So, for example, I was just at the DreamPlex co-working space, and I told them there's a meetup called the Lean Startup Meetup. So if you're building a startup, you can go to this meetup, and they have events, and you can sign up for it, and you can join it. You can meet other people who are also building a startup, and then you're part of the community. Then you can network, and then you can meet other people. And then if you need an advisor, or you need to hire employees, or you need someone else to love your business idea and join with you and start a company, you can find people like that if you have a good network. And in Silicon Valley, people are very good at this. There's so many events, and so many meetups, and so many hackathons. Every single day of the week, there are too many. Possibly go to them all. And so that's something that people in Silicon Valley do a lot and very well. And so a piece of advice I would give you is to spend as much time as you can with other people who are also interested in similar things. Maybe the meetup is about, you know, agriculture and how you apply technology to agriculture. Or maybe if that's your passion and there is no meetup, you could start one yourself and invite people to it. Or maybe, you know, maybe your passion is how to be a lean startup and use that method, and then you would join the lean startup meetup. Maybe there are hackathons. We ran a hackathon earlier this year that was very popular, and we will do some more, of course. And so there are ways to get out and about and meet people and build as big a network as you can. There are two other things I want to say about Silicon Valley, and actually they're related. One is that people share a lot with each other. They help each other, they talk to each other, they discuss their problems, not just in their marriage, but in their business, and they are very open about what they're doing. There's a lot of transparency. They don't try to hide the things they're working on. they would like people to know, and they want advice, and they want to partner with other people who can help them and share ideas with them. Maybe something's going wrong and they're experiencing some failure. You know, you should be able to learn from them. You can learn yourself from mistakes that happen or something that just went wrong around you, you couldn't help it. But you can also learn from other people who had that experience. And in a lot of places, and I think this includes Vietnam, there is not as much transparency as there is in Silicon Valley. So people in the United States are very open. They share a lot with each other. And that's something we need to do as much as possible here so people can be helpful. Even in a big company like IBM, we don't try to do things by ourselves. We have a massive partner network. We derive a huge amount of our revenue from things we do with partners. There are a lot of things we don't even build ourselves. We do them only with partners, like Salesforce automation, CRM systems, things like that. We always partner for things like that. And so, you know, you should always have a good network and a good set of partners and share as much information with each other as you can. And then the last thing I'll say before we, you know, take questions is people in Silicon Valley are very good mentors, or they get very good mentors. So mentorship and coaching, people taking care of each other and giving each other advice is very common. I'm a corporate executive and I have mentors. So everyone, you know, should have this. Even if you're successful and you think you know what you're doing, even if you do know what you're doing, you can always benefit from the experience of someone else who has been in a particular kind of business or had particular kinds of problems or has particular connections. You know, there are people who can help you meet clients. They can help you get over a difficulty. They can coach you on how to hire good salespeople if you're having trouble doing it. There are lots of reasons to have. Maybe they help you negotiate, or maybe they help you get the right kind of job. So mentors are